Glioblastoma Multiforme Symptoms, Diagnosis and Treatment Options. Glioblastoma is a malignant, cancerous brain tumor that develops from a specific type of brain cell called an astrocyte. These cells help support and nourish neurons, nerve cells of the brain, and form scar tissue that helps repair brain damage in response to injury. Glioblastomas are often very aggressive and grow into surrounding brain tissue. Signs and symptoms, such as headache, nausea, vomiting and/or drowsiness, may develop when the tumor begins to put excess pressure on the brain. Affected people may also experience other features depending on the size and location of the tumor. In most cases, the exact underlying cause is unknown, however, they can rarely occur in people with certain genetic syndromes such as neurofibromatosis type 1, Turcot syndrome and Li Fraumeni syndrome. There is currently no cure for glioblastoma. Treatment is palliative and may include surgery, radiation therapy and/or chemotherapy. Symptoms of glioblastoma. Signs and symptoms of glioblastoma vary depending on the size and location of the tumor but may include headache, nausea and vomiting, drowsiness, changes in personality, weakness on one side of the body, memory loss, speech difficulty, changes in vision, and seizures. Cause of glioblastoma. In most cases, the exact underlying cause of glioblastoma is unknown. In rare cases, they can occur in people with certain genetic syndromes such as neurofibromatosis type 1, Turcot syndrome and Li Fraumeni syndrome. In these cases, affected people usually have other characteristic features of the condition that are all caused by changes, mutations, in a specific gene. Inheritance. Most glioblastomas are not inherited. They usually occur sporadically in people with no family history of tumors. However, they can rarely occur in people with certain genetic syndromes such as neurofibromatosis type 1, Turcot syndrome and Li Fraumeni syndrome. All of these conditions are inherited in an autosomal dominant manner. Diagnosis of glioblastoma. Genetic testing is not available for many people with glioblastoma since most of these tumors occur sporadically, by chance, and are not caused by a genetic mutation. However, genetic testing is an option for people with an inherited condition that predisposes to glioblastoma such as neurofibromatosis type 1, Turcot syndrome and Li Fraumeni syndrome. Carrier testing for at-risk relatives and prenatal testing are possible if the disease-causing mutation in the family is known. The Genetic Testing Registry, GTR, is a centralized online resource for information about genetic tests. It provides a list of laboratories performing genetic testing for neurofibromatosis type 1, Turcot syndrome and Li Fraumeni syndrome. The intended audience for the GTR is healthcare providers and researchers. Patients and consumers with specific questions about a genetic test should contact a healthcare provider or a genetics professional. Glioblastoma is typically diagnosed based on a physical exam that identifies characteristic symptoms and various imaging studies such as computed tomography (CT) and/or magnetic resonance imaging (MRI). A CT scan is an imaging method that uses X-rays to create pictures of cross-sections of the body, while an MRI scan uses powerful magnets and radio waves to create pictures of the brain and surrounding nerve tissues. These imaging studies will also provide information regarding the size of the tumor and which parts of the brain are affected. Surgical removal of the tumor or a small biopsy may confirm the diagnosis. Treatment for glioblastoma. Glioblastoma treatment options include surgery to remove the glioblastoma. Your brain surgeon, neurosurgeon, will work to remove the glioblastoma. The goal is to remove as much of the tumor as possible. But because glioblastoma grows into the normal brain tissue, complete removal isn't possible. For this reason, most people receive additional treatments after surgery to target the remaining cells. Radiation therapy. Radiation therapy uses high-energy beams, such as X-rays or protons, to kill cancer cells. During radiation therapy, you lie on a table while a machine moves around you, directing beams to precise points in your brain. Radiation therapy is usually recommended after surgery and may be combined with chemotherapy. For people who can't undergo surgery, radiation therapy and chemotherapy may be used as a primary treatment. Chemotherapy. Chemotherapy uses drugs to kill cancer cells. In some cases, thin, circular wafers containing chemotherapy medicine may be placed in your brain during surgery. The wafers dissolve slowly, releasing the medicine and killing cancer cells. After surgery, the chemotherapy drug temozolomide, Temodar, taken as a pill, is often used during and after radiation therapy. Other types of chemotherapy may be recommended if your glioblastoma recurs. These other types of chemotherapy are often administered through a vein in your arm. Tumor treating fields, TTF, therapy. TTF uses an electrical field to disrupt the tumor cell's ability to multiply. TTF involves applying adhesive pads to your scalp. The pads are connected to a portable device that generates the electrical field. TTF is combined with chemotherapy and may be recommended after radiation therapy. Targeted drug therapy. Targeted drugs focus on specific abnormalities in cancer cells that allow them to grow and thrive. The drugs attack those abnormalities, causing the cancer cells to die. Bevacizumab, Avastin, targets the signals that glioblastoma cells send to the body that cause new blood vessels to form and deliver blood and nutrients to cancer cells. Bevacizumab may be an option if your glioblastoma recurs or doesn't respond to other treatments. Clinical trials. Clinical trials are studies of new treatments. These studies give you a chance to try the latest treatment options, but the risk of side effects may not be known. Ask your doctor whether you might be eligible to participate in a clinical trial. Supportive palliative care. Palliative care is specialized medical care that focuses on providing relief from pain and other symptoms of a serious illness. Palliative care specialists work with you, your family, and your other doctors to provide an extra layer of support that complements your ongoing care. Palliative care can be used while undergoing other aggressive treatments, such as surgery, chemotherapy, or radiation therapy.